Yes, good morning, Four Pine. Four Pine, I am audible and visible to everyone. Four Pine. Good morning, Four Pine. Yes, Four Pine, I am not able to understand you, whether I am visible or not, whether I am visible and audible to everyone or not. Quickly write over the chat box. And everyone mute your microphone. Mute your microphone and switch off your front camera. Ragini, switch off your front camera. Yes, that means I am visible and audible to everyone. A very good morning to everyone. Okay, today we will do the math magic. As you know that in Skype we are doing math magic and in offline we are doing the composite maths. Okay, so quickly come to the math magic book. In our previous class, we have completed chapter number 5, that is the way the world looks. Okay, and today we will start from chapter number 6, that is the junk seller. The junk seller. Clear? We will start the junk seller. So everyone take out page number 60 of your math magic book, and the chapter name is the junk seller. Shaurya is writing, we can't see here teachers, we can't write also. Why Shaurya? Others, they are not saying like this. I think might be a problem in your net connection. Okay, you check your net connection. Yes. See, I am reading the book, you just go through it. Okay. And in this chapter, the junk seller, you will get a concept of multiplication. So, in composite maths, you will practice multiplication chapter, which is related to the junk seller in the math magic. Okay. So, let us start the chapter. Have you ever met a kabadi wala, a woman who sells? It is kabadi wali, not wala. Have you ever met a kabadi wali, a woman who sells junk? This is a true story told by Kiran, who has a junk shop in Patna. Now, kabadi wali. Do you know what is kabadi wali? Do you, Aishwarya, switch off your front camera. Adrija, switch off your front camera. Deepona, disconnect and join again. Disconnect and join again, Deepona. Okay, now I think you all know what is the meaning of kabadi wali. Only Adrija is writing. Do you know what is kabadi wali? Write the answer in the chat box. What is kabadi wali? Yes, kabadi wali means a person or a lady who is selling the junks. Now, what is junks? What is junks? Junks means the old newspapers, the old magazines and the old things, that is called the junks. Okay. So this is known as kabadi wali, those who are selling this type of things, the old things. Now this is a story of Kiran who lives in Patna and she has a junk shop. She is just narrating the story that the see what she is saying. I studied in a Hindi medium school in my village. My father wanted girls to study like boys. Now she is saying that we used to read in a Hindi medium school and my father, he was very fond of studying. That's why she want that the girls should also read like the boys. I loved Hindi and science, but I hated maths. Today maths is most useful for my work. I could never imagine this in school. Now she is saying that when I was in the Hindi medium school, Hindi and science was the favorite subject for me, but I hate maths. I didn't want to read maths. Okay, but nowadays she is saying, but now is maths a very useful for my work. Means now this subject, math subject, is very useful to her. But when she was in the school, she never imagined that how the maths is important. So I think you all know that maths is a very important subject, and in everyday's life you need the maths, or you need the calculations like that. Okay, so you need the maths. So maths is very important and very necessary subject for everyone. Clear? Now see what the question is. What about you? Do you also find maths difficult? Yes, write the answer over the chat box. Whether maths is difficult for you also? Is it difficult for you? Maths is difficult for you? Okay, all are saying no. Very good. If it is no, that means you all love maths. You all love maths? Yes, Shailaja is saying yes. Sometimes it is difficult. I agree with Audrija that sometimes it is difficult, but maximum times if you are not feared of maths, okay, it will not make you. Okay, now the second question is, what is the most difficult thing in your maths book up to chapter number 5? Any of the chapter is difficult for you? Any of the chapter up to chapter number 5, is it difficult for you? No. Okay, that means up to chapter number 5 there is none of the chapters difficult for you. Very nice. Now what do you think is the easiest lesson? So up to chapter number 5, can you tell me which chapter is the easiest for you? Which chapter is the easiest for you up to chapter number 5? Tanvi, write the answers. You are not writing anything. I am not getting any answers from your side. Tanvir, Sheikh Tanvir, quickly write the answers what I am asking. I am not getting any of the answers from you. Okay, the girls are saying that a trip to Bhopal is the easiest chapter. A trip to Bhopal is the easiest chapter. Very nice. Yes, you all are correct. The chapter A Trip to Bhopal, it is very easy, isn't it? All the chapters up to chapter number 5, it is easy except the long and short, isn't it? Long and short, it is a tricky chapter. So I think it is a little bit difficult for you. But if you will, Tanvir is saying building with brick. Building with bricks such as easy chapter, isn't it? Building with bricks is such an easy chapter. It is related to patterns. Okay, never mind. Which is the chapter difficult for you? You practice it, then it will be easier for you. Okay, it will be easier for you. What are the chapters that are difficult to you? Just you practice that chapter more and more, then you will see that chapter is the easiest chapter for you. Clear? Yes. Now come to the story. See what she is saying after that. When I was young, my father died in an accident. So my mother worked as a servant in some houses. We had a difficult time. I had to leave school after class 8. I wanted to study more, but my mother got me married. Now Kiran, she is saying that when she was very young, at that time her father died because of an accident, and at that time it was very difficult for them. So she has left the studies, she has left up to class, she has read up to class 8 only, and her mother, she used to work as a servant in some of the houses to earn money. Okay, and as she was young, so to a very early age she got married. Her mother got her married. Okay, now after that she is saying that my husband's family lived in a mud house. His two brothers and his sister did not go to school. He had a tea stall. Now he is saying that my husband, means Kiran's husband, they all lived in a mud house with their family, and in the family there were two brothers and a sister. These children, they have never gone to a school. In fact, the husband, he has a tea stall. Okay, the husband, he was running a tea stall. Now the next one, come to page number 61. Come to page 61. Find out how much for a cup of tea. Ask people and find out the cost of a cup of tea at a tea stall, at a hotel. Now this is the question that you have to find out, that a cup of tea, what is the price of a cup of tea in a tea stall and in a hotel. In a tea stall means when you are passing by any road, you can see there is a stall of tea, like that. Okay, so you have to say what is that, or when you are in a station, you can see it is written that tea stall. So in this type of shop, what is the cost of a cup of tea, that you have to write. And the same tea, what is its cost when you are taking it in a hotel, in a 5-star or 7-star hotel, what is the cost. Okay, Deboshmi is writing 5 and 10. No Deboshmi, nowadays it is not rupees 5. When you are taking a tea in a tea stall, it is near about 10 rupees. Okay, it is near about 10 rupees. And the same tea when you are taking in a hotel or in a 5-star or 7-star hotel, it will be rupees 50. Okay, it will be rupees, near about rupees 50. So just this activity you can do of your own also. You can just ask the cost of the tea in a tea stall. They will say it is near about 10 rupees, and in a hotel they will say it is near about 50 rupees. Okay, near about 50 rupees. Yes, now come to the next one. See, there is a question. If a person who runs a tea stall earns rupees 30 in a day, how much will he earn in 10 days? Now the question is that in one day, if the tea stall earns rupees 30, then in 10 days how much earning he will do. One day is given, you have to find for 10 days. So what you will do, addition, subtraction or multiplication? What you will do? Is it addition or subtraction or multiplication? What you will do? Cost of one day is given, you have to find for cost of 10 days. And after that, and in a month, cost of you have to find. Means in one day, then in 10 days, and then in a month, that is 30 days. Yes, the answer is correct. It is multiplication. You have to multiply, isn't it? One day is given, you will find for 10 days, and then you will find for 1 month. And as you know, 1 month, it means 30 days, isn't it? So you will find for 30 days. Now this question you will write in the copy. So kindly take out your copy. In the new page, write chapter number 6, the junk seller, and start writing from page number 61. Okay, page number 61. Quickly take out your copy. Take out your copy. Write the chapter's name. and page number is 61. Question number 1. Earning for one day is given. You have to find earning for 10 days. So you will write earning of the man. Earning of the man in one day is equals to rupees 30. Therefore, earning of the man in 10 days is equals to rupees 30 into 10, that is rupees 300, isn't it? You all have written rupees 300. Yes, Tanbir, you are correct. It is rupees 300. Musharraf, where is the answer from your side? Okay, now the next one. For 1 month you have to find. For 1 month. Ragini, switch off your front camera. LLY. I think I have told you what is it means. LLY. LLY. It means similarly. Okay, it means similarly. You have done in class 3, isn't it? LLY. That means similarly. So, similarly, earning of the man, earning of the man in 1 month. 1 month means it is 30 days, isn't it? 1 month means 30 days. That means rupees 30 into 30. For 1 day it is rupees 30, so for 30 days it will be 30 into 30, that is rupees 900. That is rupees 900. Okay, so answer you will write that the person earns rupees 300 in 10 days and rupees 900 in 30 days. Okay, the person earns rupees 300 in 10 days and rupees 900 in 30 days. I think this question is clear to everyone. Okay, now come to the next. Again she is saying, I thought of starting my own business. I thought I should open a bangle shop or a tailor shop. But my uncle said that we could earn a lot by opening a junk shop. Now she was thinking to open her own shop, and she thought that open her business. She thought that to open a bangle shop or a tailor shop. But her uncle told that to open a junk shop, rather to open a junk shop. So in 2001, my mother-in-law and I opened a junk shop. We took a loan of rupees 8,000 for the shop. Now she is saying that in the year 2001. We have started our business, that is of junk seller business, and we have taken a money of 8,000 as a loan, and with that rupees 8,000 they have started the business. Now the question is, find out what is a loan. Now do you know what is a loan? Do you know what is a loan? Acha, the problem for the board is for everyone. Adrija is saying that it is in half. Others, let me know. The board is coming half. But I don't think it is coming half. It is full. I can see. Four pine, it is full. Adrija, you check your net connection. Yes. Adrija, you check your own net connection because all are saying that it is proper. Okay. Might be you have the net problem. Yes. Devoshmi is saying that loan is the car loan, house loan. Yes, all the students, just mute your microphone. Everyone mute your microphone. Everyone mute your microphone. Yes, see, loan is a type of money you are taking from bank or from any person, and that money either you are taking to buy a car or you are taking to buy a house or you are taking that money to go abroad for to have higher studies like this. Okay, it will be for anything. So that money you are taking either from the bank or from someone, for that you have to give a interest and you have to pay it back to that person or to the bank. Okay, so here is the question: have you ever heard of someone taking a loan for what? Yes, you have heard that they are taking the loan either for the house or for the vehicles, as Devoshmi has written, isn't it? So that type of loan you can take it. Now, how much loan was taken? That is up to them, that what amount of money they have taken, how much money was paid back. Now this you have to find it out, that whether you have heard someone has taken the loan and how much money in return they have to give, that also you can find. Now after that, there is the about Hariya and Babu. Hariya and Babu went to buy a hand cart for rupees 300. Now Hariya and Babu, they have gone to buy a hand cart whose cost is rupees 300. Now the question is, I have taken a loan of rupees 300 from a bank for 6 months. I will pay rupees 51 every month to the bank. Now Hariya, he is saying that I have taken a 300 rupees loan from bank and I have to pay rupees 51 every month up to 6 months. That means he is paying 51 rupees every month for 6 months. Whereas Babu, what he has done? Babu is saying that, but I have taken a loan of rupees 300 from Chunnilal. After 6 months, I will pay back rupees 360. Now he is saying that I have taken a loan of rupees 300 as same as you have taken, but I have taken from Chunnilal, whereas Hariya has taken from bank. Now he is saying, Babu is saying that after 6 months, I have to return rupees 360 to Chunnilal for rupees 300. Okay, this was the money they are returning back, but they have got the same money from the bank and from Chunnilal. Now the question is, who has to pay back more, Hariya or Babu? You have to say that who has to pay back more money. Is it Hariya or is it Babu? Adrija, switch off your front camera. Adrija, switch off your front camera. Yes, you all are saying Babu. It is correct. Babu has to pay more money. But for this, you have to calculate. Okay. So take out your copy and then start writing in the copy. The answer is correct. It is Babu. But how it is Babu, that you will find out. So write in the copy. This question, you write it in your copy. These all are word problems. These all are word problems. Okay, the same page, number second. You will write that money paid by Hariya. in 1 month is equals to rupees 51. Therefore, money paid by Harya in 6 months. 6 months, that means rupees 51 into 6, that is rupees 306, isn't it? Whereas Babu has to pay rupees 360 after 6 months. After 6 months, that means Babu has to pay more money than Harya. Okay, so you will write the answer that hence Babu, has to pay. Hence, Babu has to pay more money than Harya. Okay. Hence, Babu has to pay more money than Harya. Understood this question? Okay, 4 point. Today up to this only. You practice page number 60 and 61 at home. And we will do the next chapter in our next class. Okay. So, bye all of you for today.